Blue Origin achieved significant milestones on path to New Glenn Rocket's debut flight. Blue Origin, the aerospace company founded by Jeff Bezos, has recently reached several important milestones in its programs, signaling progress towards the inaugural launch of its highly anticipated New Glenn rocket. These achievements include successful firings of the BE-4 engine beneath the Vulcan rocket, infrastructure enhancements at the launch pad, and securing the prestigious contract for the Artemis V lunar lander. These developments mark a significant improvement for Blue Origin compared to its previous challenges, including rocket delays and difficulties in securing contracts. The company is also actively exploring the possibility of a fully reusable New Glenn rocket, which could revolutionize space travel. Infrastructure advancements. Over the past few months, Blue Origin has made significant progress on the construction of its vertical assembly building and the Reef Pathfinder building. The latter is associated with the assembly and work on Blue Origin's ambitious Orbital Reef space station. Situated at the company's campus at Cape Canaveral, the Orbital Reef Station is a collaborative project between Blue Origin and Sierra Space, with plans to commence operations in 2027. Blue Origin's primary contribution to the station will be launch services, utilizing the New Glenn rocket to deploy the station into orbit and transport crew members and cargo to and from the station once it becomes operational. While the exact purpose of the vertical assembly building remains undisclosed, it is expected to play a vital role in New Glenn's construction efforts at Cape Canaveral. The building currently features a fully constructed frame, although Blue Origin has yet to reveal specific details about its updated plans for the structure. According to approved development plans, Blue Origin intends to expand its Exploration Park campus by adding several new buildings to its southern side. These include a chemical processing facility, composite assembly building, and more. However, construction work on these buildings has not yet commenced. Testing activities at Cape Canaveral Blue Origin recently resumed its fairing drop tests, which involve using a helicopter to drop one of the halves of a New Glenn payload fairing into the ocean, allowing for recovery and potential reuse in future missions. These tests, currently in the early stages, mirror the approach taken by SpaceX in recovering their payload fairings. Although the test results have not been confirmed at the time of writing, temporary flight restrictions, TFRs, and Marine Safety Information Bulletins, MSIBs, were posted, indicating the drop testing taking place near Cape Canaveral between June 27th and June 30th. Furthermore, observers have spotted a New Glenn upper stage test tank within the tank cleaning and testing facility located at Blue Origin's Exploration Park campus. The purpose of this tank remains unclear, as it could be undergoing various types of testing such as fit checks, tank cleaning, or pressure tests. Similarly, a first stage related tank was also observed within the facility, but its precise role in the testing process has not been confirmed. Another notable achievement for Blue Origin was the successful full vertical erection of the New Glenn Transporter Erector at Space Launch Complex 36, SLC 36. Compared to previous sightings, the erected transporter erector featured additional installed hardware, including a circular frame at its base with a large hexagonal cutout in the middle. This configuration aligns with earlier renders shared by the company. Undoubtedly, one of the most significant testing endeavors at Blue Origin's Cape Canaveral facility is its reusable second stage development program, known as Project Jarvis. The Jarvis test tanks were constructed and tested in a tented area adjacent to SLC 36, where they were observed alongside header tanks and regular tanks. Furthermore, during a recent flyover by the National Science Foundation, NSF, ring sections were identified that could potentially be utilized in the construction of a new Jarvis tank. If realized, this development could position New Glenn as one of the world's first fully reusable launch vehicles, aligning with SpaceX's ambitious goal of achieving full reusability with its Starship program. The newly constructed test stand at the Glenn Stage 1 test area, located next to the launch pad, could facilitate various tests for Blue Origin. This area is connected to ground support equipment, GSE tanks, and may play a role in the ongoing first stage tank testing efforts conducted by Blue Origin at Cape Canaveral. Successful B-4 engine firing beneath Vulcan rocket. Reports from both United Launch Alliance, ULA, and Blue Origin have confirmed the flawless performance of the B-4 engine during the Flight Readiness Firing, FRF test, conducted on ULA's Vulcan rocket. While the Vulcan's launch in 2023 may face delays due to Centaur upper stage issues, The successful B-4 engine test paves the way for Blue Origin's involvement in the rocket's future flights. Notably, the same B-4 engines used in the Vulcan rocket's first stage will also power New Glenn. Blue Origin has not yet confirmed whether the specifications for the Vulcan and New Glenn B-4 engines will be identical. Since the initial Vulcan rockets will not feature a reusable first stage engine, it remains a possibility that New Glenn will have distinct specifications. According to the information shared by Blue Origin, New Glenn will be designed for reusability from the outset. Contract wins an Artemis V mission. In a momentous achievement, NASA awarded the highly coveted Artemis V lunar lander contract to the national team, led by Blue Origin. Valued at over $3 billion, this contract represents the largest contract ever secured by Blue Origin. The company will also invest a significant amount of its own funds in the lander's construction, ensuring readiness for the third crewed lunar landing mission of NASA's Artemis program, currently slated for approximately 2029. The Artemis V lander, which will have a reusable configuration, is designed to transport 20 metric tons of payload to the lunar surface. It will be launched aboard the New Glenn rocket, while Northrop Grumman's cislunar transporter will provide in-orbit refueling services for the lander. For the Artemis III and IV landing missions, SpaceX's Starship has been selected as the primary landing vehicle. New Shepard returned to flight operations. Following a failure during the uncrewed NS-23 flight in September 2022, Blue Origin temporarily grounded its New Shepard suborbital rocket. The failure was attributed to a malfunctioning engine nozzle on the BE-3 engine, which led to a loss of control and the termination of the flight. Since then, Blue Origin has been diligently working on resolving the issues and is now poised to resume operations of the New Shepard rocket in the upcoming weeks, as revealed in an interview with Bob Smith at the Investing in Space event by the Financial Times. Once the return to flight date for New Shepard is confirmed, the campaign for the 24th mission of the New Shepard program will commence. Notably, the New Shepard program has experienced only one major anomaly thus far. In summary, Blue Origin's recent accomplishments underscore its steady progress towards the debut flight of the New Glenn rocket. Advancements in infrastructure, successful testing activities, the flawless B-4 engine firing, winning the Artemis V lander contract, and the imminent resumption of New Shepard operations all contribute to Blue Origin's growing position in the space industry. As the company continues to innovate and overcome challenges, it solidifies its role as a key player in the future of space exploration and transportation.